right on a bad bed. I doubled down on a sinking ship.
Hi guys, I'm here with Della.
Hi.
We're at camp, and I'm going to try to vlog the whole trip. I don't know how it's going to go, but yeah, it's going to be really fun. We're at dinner, we're going to be eating, and yeah, there's Spider-Man right now, and it's pretty cool. But yeah, so this is going to be super cool and fun, and it's already hot, and I'm sweating buckets. But you know, it's going to be cool.
There's a fire starting in my heart, reaching a fever pitch and it's bringing me out the dark.
Getting to do as much vlogging as I was hoping to, which really sucks. But it's the last day of camp, and everyone's heading out and packing up, and we're about to get back on the bus and go home. But this was probably the best experience I've ever had. I met so many amazing people, learned so much, and honestly, it was great. Just everything I could have asked for. All my best friends were here, and here I am. Mess hall is all empty. It's time to go. Everyone, say hi. Here's everyone.
Hello.
Hey.
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 Hi.
Hey.
Hey.
Okay. This is the last day at camp, and we're on the bus going back, and it was the greatest thing ever. Does anyone have anything they want to say?
I'm gonna miss everyone here.
I know.
For
I love you all.
Camp is
we're
love.
All queer.
Love is love.
And lost folks.
Yeah. Lost folks.
Lost folks. 2K15.
So you
know, we need
even wearing a green hat, it makes me happy.
But yeah, it was amazing, and I somehow didn't get bit by any bugs, which I am like absolutely feeling that.
You didn't even manage that.
I have no idea. I wore shorts like almost every day.
You did wear shorts like every day but today.
Yeah, exactly. And oh my gosh, the campfire was so much fun. And singing songs and then poems and scary stories. Scary stories that made us not sleep.
Even like Molly.
Oh my god.
That was terrifying.
What was Molly?
Were you not there?
Oh, we're telling
I wasn't
Molly.
There. I got tired, so I just left.
Tell the story.
I don't know how it begins.
Okay, so this girl went to
a therapist.
A therapist. We
because she had this fear, I don't know what it's called, where she's scared of anything that's in between. So like say there's a bed and a wall, that in between space, she's scared of stuff like that, or like light and dark, that in between space. So she went to his therapist and he did this method where he would slowly get her over her fear over time. Now, a few months beforehand, the police had found this couple where their lips had been sewn shut in an abandoned house. So, okay, so back to Molly. Molly went to the therapist and he put her on this treatment where he would, where she had a lamp and she was in the darkness for a long time, and so if she was scared of anything, she would click the little string of her lamp and everything would be better. So Molly's laying in her bed that night, she's asleep and she hears a crashing noise in her room. She freaks out and the lamp has fallen. And so the cars go by her window, and she sees a headlight comes by, comes through,
and there's handprints on the window.
And so Molly's freaking out, and she looks for her lamp, and turns out it's in the space between her bed and the wall. She is terrified. She is screaming. Now, apparently, her dad didn't want, thought that the therapist was being too slow, so he decided to do this treatment, which is extremely dangerous, and just throw it in there and until they get over it. Like, throw their fear at them until they're over it.
So he locks her in her room. So she's locked in the room, and the entire night she's screaming and crying, and she wants to get out so badly, and then finally the screaming stops. Then the next morning, when the father comes in, he goes in and hugs Molly tightly, and he says, "Are you all right, sweetie?" And she said, "Molly's all right now. She's with us." And then
the mom screams in the doorway, and he doesn't turn around. He's too freaked out, and he feels something.
And it's splatter. And he goes to his face, and he rubs it off his face, and there's blood all over his hand.
And before he has time to react, Molly bites him in the neck. Next morning, Molly's missing.
The police find the bodies in the house with the lips sewn shut,
and dad
has a newspaper sewn to his hands. All the food's still on the table, like they were setting up for breakfast. And so the therapist, not knowing that like Molly was gone yet, is in his office, and he has his like feet underneath his desk and everything. Molly's missing, but he hasn't gotten any word back yet. So he feels his shoe slip off, and so he slowly looks under his desk, and there's nothing there. And he freaks out. He puts his shoe back on, takes his stuff out. Like, I'm going home. I'm getting the fuck out of here.
Truly.
And so he's going to his car that's right underneath the lamp, and he looks over, and there's Molly.
Ooh, it was a lot spooky.
It was a lot scary around the campfire.
It was definitely a lot scary around the campfire.
It was like night and really
like, there was
scary.
Like chills and like people are screaming.
We were like all holding hands screamed. And like
it was pretty scary.
We were like, no,
and the guy told it in a way creepier way than we did.
True. Oh,
yeah. Jack definitely took it totally.
Yeah. It was so scary. Oh my god. Like I don't typically get scared by scary stories, but
everyone was like screaming and clenching, like holding hands with each other, and probably like almost breaking.
I was holding onto Roman's hand, like, oh my god, I'm gonna die.
I was like, holding Cedric's hand like this, and I'm like, hold me.
For the record, Roman grabbed my hand first, because he was scared before me, so I mean, I'm not.
That's so funny.
I'm macho.
I love Roman.
Oh my gosh. But yeah, that was amazing, and the night before we sang tons of songs. It's raining right now.
It's definitely raining, and it's nice.
Oh. We sang lots of songs, and then...
What?
You.
Yeah, I taught people how to write slam poetry,
yeah.
And we, after the scary stories, we did a poetry slam. It was awesome.
It was super emotional and
so
like, it was cathartic and really cool.
Yeah.
And
poetry can be healing.
Altogether, it was a really great experience, and I feel so much closer to the people that are in this bus right now than to really anyone I've been around in a long time. And they're all just wonderful and kind and nice and legitimate, and yeah, it was great. love you too, Nova.
I love you.
Woo! I love all of you guys.
I love everyone too.
I've never loved awesome. Somebody so fast.
Everything is awesome. Everything is cool when you're part of a team. Everything is awesome when you're part of a team. Okay, yeah, I guess this is where I'm gonna end the vlog. But yeah, it was great. I can't, I hope I get to go to another one. Or
you will.
Just experience something as great as this. Alright, bye!
Bye!
Bye! Bye.